still remember back in time when I was just a lad of nine, and you and Tenzing touched the sky and climbed atop the world. It soon became my boyhood dream to visit places yet unseen and climb into those mountains high with banners to unfurl. As I grew, my dreams did too. You were my hero through and through. I followed your adventures too, around the planet wide. From Everest to Makalu, across the Antarctic too. You were my inspiration, my mentor and my guide. Sir Ed, to me you were a hero. Sir Ed, in Nepal you were a god. Sir Ed, in your own land, just a very special man who left the world much better where you trod. When Tashi was a boy of 10, he still recalls the moment when you strode into his village high, where Everest's inside. With hammer, nails and saw and rule, you set to work and built a school so he could start to join the world and learn to read and write. Hospitals and water schemes, these were only things of dreams among the Sherpa people then, for poverty was rife. As Cholmolongma's peak stood high, the mother goddess in the sky, a mortal god had come to help them lead a better life. Sir Ed, to me you were a hero. Sir Ed, in Nepal you were a god. Sir Ed, in your own land, just a very special man who left the world much better where you trod. Even though you love to roam, you always made New Zealand home, the country that had taught you all the values you stood for. Honest and dependable, adventurous yet humble, a family man, a statesman, a Kiwi to the core. Been among those mountains too that had so inspired you from your first day on Olivier and into Mount Cook's cloud. We trace your path across Nepal, admire what you've done for all. New Zealand's inspiration, you made this nation proud. Sir Ed, to me you were a hero. Sir Ed, in Nepal you were a god. Sir Ed, in your own land, just a very special man who left the world much better where you trod. Sir Ed, you are New Zealand's hero.